Imagine you're a technician, and you've just been handed a computer that's behaving strangely. Now imagine that you know nothing about the language of its software, or how information is stored across all its tiny transistors. Imagine that you can only scan its circuit boards for physical damage, probing one circuit at a time and making repairs with a soldering iron. Until recently, that's where we were in neuroscience. But research in neuroengineering at the Tsai Neurosciences Institute is changing that. New tools are enabling scientists to record, measure, and manipulate activity in the brain at unprecedented scales, from the movements of single molecules to the coordinated activity of millions of neurons. Powerful microscopes let scientists watch as connections between brain cells are created and destroyed, a process critical to learning and memory. By deciphering the codes that turn neural activity into motor movements, neuroengineers are pioneering prosthetic limbs that can be controlled entirely by a person's thoughts. They are miniaturizing implantable devices that can interrupt pain signals, and they are developing wearable devices that can predict the cycles of depression. And using new brain imaging techniques, they are revealing how connections form in the brain as a child learns to read, leading to new ways to help struggling students. Each new tool and device produces new kinds of data. Stanford is leading the way here too, developing statistical and computational methods to analyze massive, complex, and unusual data sets. And the Institute is building a new theory center that will focus on the fundamental rules that govern how the brain encodes, transforms, and uses information to guide thought, decisions, and behaviors. But neuroengineering isn't just about understanding the brain. It's also about applying the amazing design features of the brain, evolved over millennia, to guide the design of new forms of computing and artificial intelligence. The pace of R&D in neuroengineering is breathtaking. But what really matters is whether new tools can stand up to the rigors of the laboratory and the challenges of the clinic. And that's where Stanford's interdisciplinary culture really shines. Its engineers work side by side with scientists and doctors, defining problems, imagining solutions, and creating the future of neuroscience together.